Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you doing, everyone? It's very nice to see you here. We learn today English station. So I just would like to say hello. Hope you are always healthy at home, student, lovely student of Mekar Arum. And of course, before we are going to learn about something, about describing thing of the day, so I do really would like to remind you again about our slogan of our school, our lovely school, which is deket, dede, and imat. It's supposed to be yes, 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 or in English, close, affectionate, and attentive. Yes, okay, so have fun, guys, learning with me. Isabia, I am an English teacher of Mekar Arum. So today we would like to discuss about this one. It's kind of describing place. So actually, this is the topic is about the second session from descriptive text. And then I do put some like fresh adjective in this case. So I hope this will help you to create great paragraph, and then you will put many adjectives in your descriptive paragraph. So let's begin. Carry on. See this one. I have this pretty much nice place, right? And I bet you pretty much familiar with this picture. See, I have a short paragraph here. My friend and I went to Lembang, Bandung for a long weekend. It's a fascinating place, but it's quite touristy. The best thing was the food, which was out of this world. You can see I put the red color in two words. It means I put your attention into adjective. The first word is fascinating and the second one is touristy. So, in the meantime, I do really hope that you would like to like have your ability to create your own paragraph about describing place or kind of tourism object around you in your hometown. See, get it on, and I would like to give you that job, that task, writing task, to write about your own descriptive text regarding describing place of tourism object in your hometown. There you go. For this next short paragraph, I put a nice picture too. It is about a village of girls, and I put the passage like this. I went to the countryside with my family for a couple of weeks. We stay in a very picturesque, sleepy village surrounded by some dramatic mountain scenery. So you may find three adjectives in there, kind of picturesque. It's showing kind of something. It's very beautiful. It's like a painting. So it looks like more beautiful than you can see in the picture. It described kind of like that. And then again, sleepy, it's showing about the place is very quiet and it's peaceful, kind of like that. And then dramatic mountain scenery, the dramatic showing about kind of interesting place, impressive place. So you need to think about the appropriate adjective to put in your text when you would like to describe the place, a beautiful place. So, and then again, this one, regarding to the text about those boats, I have already shown you. So, quite, just wait. Then, what is adjective? Before I'm going to talk about that, this one, you can see this picture, a monster, the monster. What do you think it is? Is it an adjective? No, of course not. The monster is a noun. Noun in Bahasa Indonesia is kata benda. You are a student. A student is a noun. I am a teacher. A teacher is a noun. So, we cannot find adjective here. There is no adjective. This is noun. And, see again. Could you find adjective in this picture? Yes, it is. Green. Green is an adjective. So, we could learn when you put an adjective in a short word, it can help you give more detail into it, right? How about this one? Where is the adjective from the word of lighthouse, villa, and then beam house? The adjective is just beam. Of course, the lighthouse is a noun, villa is a noun, and house is a noun. Only one adjective in this case, beamed. So it's kind of like the house full of light. And then again, see this one. I take you into some or introduce you into some adjective in English or vocabulary in English regarding to house. When you find the picture like the first one, detached house, you may say detached house. It's quite different with semi-detached house and then terrace house. It's kind of, in Bahasa Indonesia, you may say rumah susun, kind of like that. So you might find appropriate word to describe the word of house. It's a little bit different. Detached, semi-detached, and then terrace. Different. There you go again. I give you this one as a picture. As you may notice that this adjective is always describe a noun. What about this one? Adjectives also gives more information about something, right? When I give you this picture, what adjective, what kind of adjective in your mind? You might see the picture has a blue color and then the environment is very dirty and then it's have more garbage in there, like scattered, garbage is around. So the blue is biru in Bahasa Indonesia and then dirty is kind of kotor and then scattered is berantakan ya, messy. Di mana-mana berantakan. Jadi sampahnya berantakan. There you go again. When I give you this picture, what is in your mind regarding adjective things? This picture is showing a village, right? It's quite clean and then it takes your breathtaking or breathtake like take your breath away, kind of like that. Breathtaking, it's kind of impressive and then picturesque and then boring, could be boring because it is so very silent or quiet or too peaceful. And then sleepy, it's also showing that this village is very really pretty much peaceful. It could be sleepy. And then again, friendly, it's supposed to the people itself, to the people who lives in the village. So it might be the people around who lives in village is very much friendly. And then again, see this one. Can you, although have you ever come to this kind of place? It's quite crowded, right? It's pretty much cosmopolitan, could be, or it is noisy, and it's supposed to be like pretty much, oh, crowded. I put the word of crowded twice, sorry for that. And then again, see, I give you some adjective to describe about places. It might help you when you want to write your own paragraph about describing place or about tourism object in your hometown. See this one, you might find cosmopolitan, touristy, polluted, which means polluted is dirty or dangerous for your health when you breathe the air. And then again, vibrant, kind of full of energy of life, and then again, deserted, and thriving, stunning. So it's quite a nice word to say something. Stunning, it is about beautiful, like picturesque, like impressive, like amazing, like wonderful place, kind of like that. Medieval, it's showing something and relating to Middle Age about historical building, could be like that. And then again, Talking about the jackdip, you have noticed, you have already noticed that it always describes a noun and it always gives more information about something, give more information about the place that you would like to describe in your writing. See this one, when you see kind of like this picture, you might it might remind you some adjective that come and show up in your mind, like fantastic picture, relaxing place, wooden house, the house made from wood, kind of like that, and then gray, yeah, and then again young. What is young? The boy itself, and then again there is many color put in there. Color included into adjective too because it describe noun, describe a thing. And there you go. Here they are. Talking about adjective again, you might put some adverb like very, really, too, before an adjective. Like it's hot, you may put very hot. Like in this one, it's cold, it's really cold. You might put these three words when you want to add something or when you want to add the degree of that adjective itself. It's showing a quantity of the adjective itself. So too hot, which mean it is more than usual quantity or yeah, kind of like that. And then again, see this one. If you remember again about adjective, just make sure that you don't put s after an adjective because adjective cannot be counted. Only noun can be counted. For example, one red car. That's correct, right? Two, you may say you have two cars and then you would like to say two red cars. That correct because you put S after cars. S only put in a noun because noun could be more than one, but adjective cannot be, so it cannot be counted. And then again, two red scar, I put the symbol of cross, it's showing that it is incorrect. Reds cannot be correct, it is incorrect. Like in the part of the right part, I show a dog, one brown dog, two brown dogs, we put dogs as in the word of dogs, and then again 20 brown dogs. Do not put s in the word of brown because brown is an adjective. There you go. Where do we put an adjective? Before I'm going to talk about this one, let's just see some commercial break about our lovely school. Happy watching, everyone. Have a great watching.
Kamu siswa kelas 9 dan bingung mau melanjutkan ke sekolah mana? Saya kasih informasi nih. Memilih sekolah itu sangat menentukan masa depan loh. Pilihan sekolah yang tepat membuat masa depan Anda bermartabat. Ayo, sekolah bersama kami di SMA Mekar Arum Cilinyi. Beberapa alasan mengapa harus sekolah SMA Mekar Arum, karena SMA Mekar Arum merupakan sekolah yang bernuansa art and science school. SMA Mekar Arum memiliki ciri khas religius, akademik, smart school, unggul dalam pendidikan karakter dan seni, serta menggunakan proses pembelajaran dengan konsep deket, dede, dan ime. Dalam pelaksanaan pembelajaran dan situasi pandemi, SMA Mekar Arum tidak hanya belajar melalui classroom saja, melainkan melakukan pembelajaran dengan memberikan fasilitas berupa pembelajaran melalui live streaming YouTube dan siaran melalui radio Barani 1116 kHz. Saat ini, SMA Mekar Arum menerima pendaftaran gelombang pertama peserta didik tahun pelajaran 2021-2022. Pendaftaran dimulai pada tanggal 15 Januari hingga 5 Maret. Tentunya, kuota terbatas, dan bebas biaya pangkal. Adapun pendaftaran dapat dilakukan secara offline maupun online. Untuk pendaftaran online, Anda bisa kunjungi website kami. Untuk pendaftaran offline, Anda bisa langsung datang ke SMA Mekar Arum di Jalan Raya Cinunuk nomor 82 Cileunyi, Kabupaten Bandung. Masih tetap bingung memilih pilihanmu? Yakin deh, SMA Mekar Arum bisa jadi solusi tepat untuk masa depanmu. Ayo datang dan daftar sekarang juga.
There you go again. So, I'm going to continue our learning, our session of English. So, this one. Where do we put an adjective in a sentence? So you need to consider which one and where we do really need to put an adjective, especially if the adjective more than one. See this one. We put an adjective before noun. When you see this an example, the green monster. The green is an adjective, monster is a noun. So we put it not like in Bahasa Indonesia. Monster hijau, monster dulu baru hijau. But in English, we put it on the contrary. Like the first one is supposed to be adjective first and then again noun. So I show you at the two sentence below, the green monster or the monster green. So it's quite very obvious that the monster green is incorrect and the green monster is correct. So put the adjective before noun. And then again, the second one, put after to be. If you would like to take to be in the sentence, put an adjective after to be. Like in the sentence, the monster is said. The to be is, and said is an adjective. And then we might want to put some adjective after the certain verbs, like be, become, feel, get, look, seem, smell, taste, and sound. We may or possible to put the adjective after that certain verb. The scenery looks nice, which means looks included into certain verbs, like I mentioned before. And then again, it smells bad. It smells bad. Bad is an adjective after certain verb, which is smells. So remember, put always S at the first verb when you find the verb is or the sentence is present simple and the subject is singular. He, she, or it. In this case, it, and then the first sentence, the scenery. The scenery is singular. There you go again. This is more example about where do we put an adjective after the certain verbs. Like the cake is great, that's after to be, of course. It smells wonderful. Wonderful after the certain verb smell. It feels soft. It feels soft. Soft after the verb of feels. And then they seem satisfied. Satisfied showing adjective after the verb seem. And then again, it looked delicious. It looked delicious. Delicious is an adjective after the verb of looks. And then it tastes. Ada S-nya ya. Amazing. Amazing after taste. The word of taste. And there you go. So, multiple adjective. Sometimes we find some adjective in one for one word only, but that one word, that one noun explain or describe by so very very long adjective. Like in Bahasa Indonesia, we can say it randomly. Like rambut saya acak-acakan, panjang, hitam. We can say it randomly. Kita boleh menempatkannya sembarang in bahasa Indonesia. But in English, we need to follow some order, follow some rule. And then we need to find which one is the first, which one we need to put the second, and then which one is the third, and so on. There you go. Give more adjective into a sentence. When you would like to give more detail about that things or the noun. For example, I would like to say the boy has red hair, right? And then I put more long sentence and I put more adjective in it, short red hair. And then again, bustling city. You might seen this picture, bustling. Bustling, it's kind of crowded city or cosmopolitan city or like busy city. Bustling city. And then I put more adjective before noun, before city. I put huge, I put international. So it takes longer and explain more to a reader. Huge, bustling, international city. That's quite interesting for the sentence if you put more into detail. There you go again. How about the order itself? How do we put the adjective into the right or correct order? So when you put like this, old brown hat, you find the noun hat, right? Hat, topi, topi bundar di situ ya. And then again, I put the next sentence, brown old hat. Which one is the correct one? Which one? So the first one is the correct one because we need to put old before, I mean it's kind of old is included into something is ancient or not or new or not, and then again brown included into the group of color, yeah, brown. And then again the second picture, Victor is the sleepy large village. That's the correct one. It's different with the second one. So how it could be? This is the or some order when you would like to put adjective more than one. Like you need to put opinion first and then followed by size and then followed by age, shape, color, origin, material, purpose, and then the last one is noun if the adjective is very long. So how do you remember this one? How could you remember this one? You just take some abbreviation of it, like OSASCOM, like that. It could be OSASCOM, opinion, size, age, shape, color, origin, material, purpose, and noun. But you need to remember that the first thing come before another adjective, you just put the ordinal or cardinal number first and then followed by opinion. And then see this one, I put some examples on it. Ugly, small, old, thin, red, Italian, cotton, sleeping bag. Well, what? Very, very long, right? And then more clear example is you just need to see that girl. And there is a sentence beside it, beautiful, long, white, French silk wedding dress. Kind of, wow, it's quite long too. But let me take you into the short one. Your hair is long, right? And your hair is black, right? You may say long black hair or black long hair. You need to say long first because long included into which one? Shape, black included into color. So we need to put long first and then black and then noun hair. Long black hair. Like in this below picture, I put some the picture of flowers. I mentioned three beautiful small flowers. Three included into ordinal or cardinal number, and then beautiful it's opinion, and then small included into the shape itself, and then flower showing it is a noun. So is that clear? I hope it is. What about all the thing about our job or our task or assignment about put or write some paragraph regarding tourism object in your hometown? I do really would like to know about your story, and you put your descriptive text in a piece of paper and then forget upload it into our Edu Learning. And I would like to see you around and waiting for your job. And don't forget, it has deadline. Yes, it has due time. Don't forget, just send it as like on time, kind of like that. Do not make it like, do not be a procrastinators. Be you and always the great in you. So thank you everyone. Hope the material of the day about adjective to describe a place will or add something valuable for you. Have a nice day. Have a great time. Deket, oh like this, okay? Deket and then dede and imet. Yes, goodbye everyone. See you around. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.